Everybody, it's the Victor. It's time to continue to hear the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yesterday's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, nor has the previous day's video either. Now, if those of you recall, it still wasn't over 5,000 likes yesterday, but people have been mass messaging me telling me that they're seeing likes disappear from YouTube, not only on my channel, but across the entire board. So I don't know what's going on with YouTube. We'll just for right now just say that every time a video hits 5,000 likes, we'll just add one to another like streak counter down below for now. For now, I'd still like to keep it where we have 24 hours in between videos, but we'll see. We'll just see how it goes. So thank you very much, everybody who's been supporting the channel thus far. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by 132. I'm not making that noise for no reason. That's literally the name. Title thread was, well, I'll be darned. The four horsemen of big time players. E. Bizzle, Polly Fizzle, R. Bizzle, and Tom Brady. Thank you very much. 132 and 175 of y'all who upvoted that one. Now the Mosh Pit Discord, or Mosh Pit Reddit, I should say, subreddit, now approaching 19,500 members. Absolutely incredible. CJ is going to be 7, Papa 3, Bravo, Mike, Delta, Whiskey, X-Ray. We've got Ghost Pepper, fantastic tiers rate, and also good damage to start with. Bad movement speed, but you know, when the movement speed is the worst thing that you can complain about, then you know what? I ain't even going to complain about it. Ghost Pepper is going to set stuff on fire and actually kill things, unlike Red Candle. No, I'm not mad at all. What are you talking about? And yeah, with a starting fire at 3.24 and 3.59 damage, I mean, like the beginning stages of this run is going to be no problem. No problem at all. I would like to get an early restock. That would be kind of nice. So the Ghost Pepper is going to fire out the blue candle-like shot that is going to trigger, I think based on our luck, which is currently negative, so we're hopefully going to find an early lucky penny. That would be good. Luck foot, a luck up pill, anything like that, assuming that we end up getting Virgo or PH Dizzle. Something to that effect. And the Book of Sin is going to drop us a consumable every time we use it. Hypothetically, anyway, we get a holy card, which is going to give us a random or a holy mantle ability. However, I'm not going to use it until we get to the next floor. Wow. The velocity of that dip, like, was incredible. I'm not going to use the holy card until the next floor because obviously we want to protect our deal with the devil. I was trying to say before I was mystified by the spawn speed of that dip. Okay, well, let's just die on floor one, I guess. A matchbook, and that is going to give us a soul heart as well. Now we don't have keys, and again, people were telling me that the matchstick does prevent the spawning of said keys. So I do want to make sure that we get key spawns. And I don't mean key spawns as in like important spawns. I hate everything right now. Get restock here. We're also probably going to have to pick up another soul heart because we just can't stop taking damage to the spikes in those rooms. This restock is going to literally restock the store at an increasing amount of money. Now, one thing that is interesting though with the matchstick, if we end up taking it and holding on to it like we are right now currently at this present moment in time, then with restock, we can kind of make up for the lack of keys by just simply buying them in the shop. So we're going to pop the holy mantle, the holy card. And again, that is designed to prevent us from losing a soul heart and possibly losing our deal with the devil or, you know, jeopardizing it in any sort of way. Ideally, we would never lose this, but, you know, the dreams don't come true in Isaac, unless, of course, you just randomly go and decide to do a full exploration and find magic, much like we did yesterday. Cough, cough, cough. But, yeah, many people have been telling me that they've been seeing their likes, their actual likes, disappearing from not only my channel, but other channels as well. You know, it's a bug that happened not that long ago on YouTube. It was a couple months ago. When it was curious to see that we saw some numbers go up and then we saw some numbers go down pretty much instantaneously. So what I think is happening is just that whenever you press the like button, it's either displaying it as you pressed it once and it actually is recording a double click, or YouTube is just crappy and bugged. I don't know. I don't know. But for now, I think that temporarily we'll probably just say that every time a new video hits 5,000 likes, then we'll just add one to the counter. But obviously the incentive there is to drive up the engagement whenever a new video comes out, because that's the crucial moment to get pushed by the algorithm. I'm just telling you for the benefit of not only my channel, but also anyone else's channel whom you might actually support here on YouTube. That's how it goes. The first couple hours is the most important, the most vital parts of any new video's life. Secret room might be here. I'm going to take a blind shot at it because we get 5 cents anyway. We can just go buy another bomb. Which did not happen, of course. There's a tinted rock here. Yeah, Magic Mush bringing everybody to the yard. And, you know, it is the Tom Brady of items. I think that was a very apt description of Magic Mush. It just makes things better. That's just what happens. So, you know, if you get Magic Mush, you know you're just going to get taken care of. And we were definitely taken care of in yesterday's run. And, you know, shout out to the Flying High episode as well, because it really does highlight how you have to sort of make your own winning strategy when it comes to just dealing with what the game gives you. And in that case, you know, the Flying Pony was instrumental in helping us the early game. And, you know, I think that episode definitely deserves to be seen by more people for sure. But also, if you don't want to see a run that, like, you know, we absolutely just like steamroll, then definitely go check that one out, because it wasn't a struggle, but it was just a good overall run. We're going to take the Book of Belialu. Also take Dead Cat to give us the 9 lives. So now we're going to be looking out for Damocles. Damocles would be awesome. I am going to go into the Cursed Room because obviously we can afford the Soul Heart, and also because of the fact that we have a Guppy item now. Hopefully we can actually get Guppy. Maybe. Probably not. Secret room might be below this room here. I need to go double check that other room above the store. Saw that little extra step there, Spider. Don't think I didn't. No reason to drop a bomb in this room here. It still could be there. It's not. Okay. So the question is now, do we go by... We go buy the key, or do we go bomb and tarot card? I would have loved to have gotten jumper cables. Actually, we should really try to get jumper cables here, because jumper cables plus Book of Sin is a very, very good combo to get. We're not done with this floor quite yet. Get one penny, and hopefully we'll get the other one here. I don't really want to go do the XL room to our right here, but I will if we have to. And we're going to be able to get it. Most likely, I mean, I'd like to save the bombs too. So, and this is not really a challenging room here, especially with us having Ghost Pepper. So, we didn't get that. 1 cent, please. Okay. So, yeah, secret room cannot be there. It's a very, very, another odd spot for the secret room here. I'm going to take a risk. Okay. Well, we're going to use our last bomb to get the donation machine withdrawal, which is, I mean, in hindsight, is what something I should have done, you know, just to get that out of the way, just the guarantee, but eh. All right, so we get jumper cables here. We're not going to take Mom's Box. Obviously, we cannot afford it because we barely could afford the jumper cables. Jumper cables are going to give us one charge on our active item every time we kill 15 enemies. So it's not a full charge. It's just a charge. And we will head on to Zaun. It was the darkness. Big time play there by wow, man. Wow. Wow game. Oh, those trolling mega troll bombs and their 30-second wicks. You gotta love it. The reason why I didn't walk out the door is because I didn't want to reset the wick. I thought it would explode a lot sooner than that. Or the, like, you know, the standard duration, but you know. There you go. Use the devil card in here. We are able to recover one of those keys back. And a whole lot of bombs. A chariot card. Okay, we got a Yave back. Could use the cherry card to get into and out of the curse room for half price. I'm not going to do that yet. I don't really want to risk this half soul heart because it looks like we're going to need it. Especially with the Book of Sin not producing us anything. In terms of HP, I mean. One of the harder rooms to not take damage in. We're going to use Ghost Pepper to destroy the Keeper here. Really hoping that there was going to be a Soul Heart in there, but of course there's not. We do have one key, but it's kind of... We don't want to be skipping item rooms right now. We could actually use Plan C against the boss, but I think that that's just kind of a waste. Oh, good. Obviously, we didn't have to use the Chariot card to get into the Curse Room, so we can use it for Super Sloth, or we can use it for the boss. We get Bob's Curse, which is going to give us 5 Poison Bombs, and do a little DOT, also known as a damage over time on any enemy that we hit with a bomb. So, Poison Damage is pretty good. Pretty good in Repentance. So hoping for a luck upgrade here so we can get some more procs on our blue fire coming from Ghost Pepper. And that's why right there it is important to have control of your damage at all times in Isaac. Because had we had any spiders at all or any attack flies or anything like that, or any familiars that would have damaged us or been able to fire on their own, like, say, Demon Baby, we would have been completely screwed. We would have gotten hit possibly multiple times in that room, and that would have been not great. So it's just... obviously, that is a tunnel in that example I'm trying to make. But you get what I mean, though. You know, it's a microcosm of illustrating how important it is to be in control of every aspect in Isaac, including your damage, which is why there are so many times that when I'm like, I don't want this item because it's because of this and this and this. It has to do with control. Child Leash. We don't really need Child Leash, so we're just going to get rid of that. The D1 Hizzle. Maybe. Let's see how many Devil Deal items we get, if any, off of this boss. If we don't get a Devil Deal, we will not take the D1 Hizzle. If we do get a Devil Deal and we take a lot of items in there, then we will use the D1 Hizzle and just see what we get. But this is a pretty darn good start. You gotta admit. I mean, I gotta admit, it's a good start. I don't really want to ruin it. Okay. I drop a Bob's Curse Bomb here. Poison just eats Gertie Jr.'s lunch. We do get a deal with the devil, and we also get Mr. Dolly. They're going to give us a nice tears up and some H Pizzle. Oh my goodness gracious. We get flying and we also get Abba Dabba Ding Dong. I don't really want the D100. Gonna be honest. I like this run. First lost, hooray. Of course, we do have now Spectral Fires, which is extremely powerful. Abaddon is going to give us some movement speed, and more importantly, is going to give us damage. And yeah. 4.07 attacks per second, 6.31 damage is pretty darn nice. PDN, pretty darn nice. I hope that doesn't stand for anything else that's bad. Got the crawl space. We had 3 soul hearts from our bedroom here. And the Backstreet Boys reunion tour is going to give us a nice amount of movement speed. Now, you definitely could argue that that should be enough to motivate us to take experimental treatment, especially for getting the spun implication there. While it is true, that does bode as a possibility. So I don't want it because I don't want it to nuke our damage or our tears rate for that matter. So we'll see. We definitely have more of a reason to take experimental treatment now than we usually do, with us possibly becoming guppy anyway. So you also have to keep in mind that we have to do a boss trap room as well, which I prefer not to do if we don't have to. Skinny Eye Mushroom is very good. It maxes out our tears rate. It does give us a damage down, but now that we have gotten Skinny Eye Mushroom, we now have a sufficient stats for me to feel like, okay, we can probably take experimental treatment and come out as a net positive here. Now, what is the thing that we want? We want damage and tears. Take it for movement speed. We don't care. What do we not want? We do not want to lose damage and tears. Yes, I am going to waste all this HP for maybe no reason. And we lost damage. And luck. More luck that we've lost now. Good. We did gain HP, which will make our next devil deal be useful. We gained movement speed, but our movement speed was already kind of okay at that point, so I don't think that we needed it. Losing the luck and the damage really sucks, because we were already losing damage, and we'll lose subsequent future damage because of Skinny Eyed Mushroom. So we wanted to have like just a bigger increase in damage, and that just didn't happen. Yeah, but now everything is, that decision is now contingent on us actually becoming spun, the getting the spun transformation. So hopefully that's going to happen. I think there's another room that we hadn't cleared over here. Actually surprised by that. Blessed Penny is pretty good. This is a chance, a small chance, mind you, but a chance to get a soul heart, a half soul heart upon acquiring a coin. Now, why that is important is because obviously we have the Head of the Keeper, and now the Head of the Keeper is going to synergize at a 25% chance. We don't know. I think it's 25%. It might be even lower than that, but the point is that it's very helpful. And we get a greed fight in our possible restock, resupply of our HP. Reverse World card is going to give us a crawl space, and we've already done unplundered the depths of the bedroom, so we don't have to worry about going into the crawl space again. Did we go to the item room? I feel like we did not go to the item room. We got a Baden and Spear of the Night from the last devil deal. Skinny Up Mushroom was found inside of the Backstreet Boys Reunion Tour was found inside of the crawl space. Yeah, I was gonna say we didn't go in. There's no way. Little Chubby making her glorious return. And we get a D4 roll. That's what I'm talking about. Blessed Penny working out great for us. So we're really hoping for Guppy. I'm going to use, again, if I were to use the reverse world card, we would get the exact same crawl space that we got the Backstreet Boys Union Tour from. Not going to deal with the devil. We get Marrow, which, yeah, not that helpful here. First, the maze. We're going to drop the crawl space just immediately. All right. Good items in their game. It's one of the spookiest things like the enemies could do in this game is just stop. Well, it is funny. It is also unsettling. Wow. They actually reached us from there. It's also weird how like some of them stop and then like some of them just don't stop. We do have a new first impressions coming up later on today in the 2 o'clock spot, so be on the lookout for that. Very interesting new game that just came out. I did not get a key to, but I decided to buy it because it just looked interesting. I will take Emperor card. Empress card, I should say. Had to watch the Houston Astros win in the top of the ninth against the much hated Boston Red Sox. I pretty much actively root against all Boston teams now. I'm sorry, Bostonians. I know. I'm very sorry that it has to be like that. But you know what? I just hate your... hate your city. I don't hate the people. I hate the city. after a horrible experience in Foxborough, which I realize is not technically Boston, but it's kind of Massachusetts, you know. I don't want Alyssa coming after me, so. I just got to be honest. I really don't root against any professional sports team except for the Saints. But now I actively root against Boston teams. I mean, like, I don't even watch hockey, and like I'll root against the Bruins now. That's right, I said it. Hockey to me has just never been, I don't know. I've never really enjoyed watching it. It's not like it's horrible. Like, I've seen way worse stuff on TV. I mean, have you seen like all these like Masked Singers and Alter Ego shows? Ugh. Talk about trash TV. Dark Bizzle. One of the big time players. Okay. Definitely want to get some more Yaves here. Blank card, I don't think we're gonna keep, but Red Candida, Pandora's Box. And Magic Fingers is 27 cents. Yeah, I think we'll just buy 4 keys here. Oh, yeah, we can't. That's right. Restock doesn't work that way anymore. Silly me. Silly Sinvicta. Getting some luck upgrades here would definitely help out with our proc rate. Turns out we didn't have to buy any of those keys, but here we are. Gonna pop the Empress card now just to make Monstro 2 a little bit easier on us. Cat of Nine Tails, and there she be. Man, what a devil deal this is. We're going to take all of these, Duality and Death's Touch and Multidimensional Baby. That is a lot of, well, one really good item. The other two kind of okay items. Fool card here. There is the elusive luck upgrade we've been searching for. Look at that. We also get a full soul heart there from the Blessed Penny. By God. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. We're going to be able to get the lead pencil, and behind it, sitting right there, is going to be the compass, which we definitely want as well. Do not want the Locust of War. Please get out of my inventory. Actually, no, I'm not going to say please. I'm just going to tell you to get out of my inventory. The lead pencil is going to fire off a Monstro's lung-esque type shot after every 15 shots, and it just adds on more damage. What does it do? It just gives you more damage. Wow, and a clear rune as well. What is going on with these claw machines here? I mean, I'll take them. I ain't gonna kick them out of bed for eating crackers, if you know what I mean, but like, seriously, like, what's going on? Things are starting to really spiral out of control here. A nickel there, and hopefully this is going to be enough to get the compass. So an easy peasy, two keys and two bombs. Super secret room might be over here. And the HP is just flowing today. Man, oh man, look at that. We've been having some pretty darn... Okay, I need to stop saying pretty darn good. We've been having some very nice, powerful runs lately. Without much of a fuss from the game, to be honest. The game hasn't done much to... Didn't actually mean to buy that, but here we are. The game hasn't been able to really do much to stop us from just absolutely destroying these runs. I'm going to go in the arcade, go get the compass. Small rock. Darn. Love to get small rock if we could. But if we don't, it's okay. As long as we have the compass. The compass is the biggest thing that we want, because obviously I want to make sure I know where the heck I'm going. And to theoretically anyway somewhat cut down on the Sinvicta navigation full clear sort of thing. Another aspect I should mention about Death's Touch right now is the fact that we have Spectral Death's Touch, which means we have piercing and spectral tears, which just give us an even greater range of movement freedom and damage mitigation by way of dodging and just being behind things and being in areas that some enemies just flat out just can't even get to. It's very good. Oh my gosh. 2020 as well, and a Hierophant card? What is going on here, man? You can just give up, game. That's fine with me. I mean, we'll beat you into submission here if we have to, but I think the game's already given up. Take Humbling Bundada, and man. This is a walk-off home run here. Actually, not even a walk-off, really. For it to be a walk-off, you have to actually be leading, or in this case, losing, and you've hit the winner, the game winner. But we've been winning since the word go on this run. Here we go, damage upgrade in tow here with a negative, and we'll head on down. So loving and playing Zedrun, the NFT horse racing game that I fell in love with only like 2 months ago. And I got to say, it's one of my favorite games to play. And just, it's got everything that I would want in a gambling game. It's got the breeding side of stuff, and some people play it like Pokemon because like they try to collect the rare skins and that sort of thing, and other people just play it for racing or for breeding and that sort of thing. I mean, the game is just so much fun. And Zedrun recently announced that they've got their first ever tournament qualifiers going on right now, and I've been trying to qualify. My lead runner, his name is Devil's Dance, and he's been doing pretty dang good. I need to remove pretty darn out of my vocabulary. Not sure what we just did, but we did a whole lot of it. Yeah, Devil's Dance has been running very, very hot lately. Named after the Metallica song, track 3 off of Reload. Wondering why our tears are like this, it's because we have, or at least we had the Are You a Wizard pill activated from that golden pill. Well, I mean. But you have to run 30 races in order to qualify for, get placed in the tournament to see where you're ranking. There's so many horses that are racing right now that like it's just the competition is crazy, and on top of that there's many, many people way better than me who know their way around like the game itself, and I'm still learning, but like I'm definitely not even like amateur level. And like, there's the whole breeding aspect to it where, you can learn how the genetics work in the game. It's got something for everybody, you know? And I'd love to do a sit down podcast with some of the more educated members in the Zedrun community. Be a lot of fun. And a good learning experience. I'm always learning about that game every single day. Surprise, the secret room is not there. We get the High Priestess reverse card, which I'm not going to do anything with. And the compass showing you why it's so important to have whenever you can get it. Not convinced. And now I'm convinced. Ah. That would be fun. That would actually, like, I would be kind of motivated to make just a Zed channel just for tracking my experiences and stuff in Zedron. That would be a lot of fun. We gotta go. We have to go Devil Deal here. The reason why I say we have to is because we're looking for Guppy, obviously. And yep. Okay. All right. Where's the blind? Don't think it really matters here in Shoal, especially with a run like this. We got Dark Bum in the his house. And we could have taken bad PhD if we really wanted to get some more stats, like some more damage and whatnot, but I don't want to lose tears. And I think the concept of a bad PhD is interesting, but it's, for my taste, is I think it's a little bit too punishing for not enough gain. You know, the fact that you can lose a primary stat but gain, but I mean, it is a nice, it's a good idea for an item because I like the fact that it always gives you something for something. You know what I mean? Like, if you're going to lose something, you're going to gain something. But sometimes that gain that you get is not necessarily something that you want to be worth. It's not worth what you've lost in any particular given instance. But if you're ahead in a run like we are right now, I mean, taking bad PhD is a good idea, I would say. I just really love our 5 attacks per second, especially the fact that we've got lead pencil here. Had to pull out the fire for a second because the bomb lamprey fly was right there. We'll head on down to the chest. Best Touch, Dark Arts, Lord of the Pit, and Dark Prince's Crown. Death List, not Death Touch, sorry. So I still make that faux pas every single time. I think Deathless can give us some luck upgrade or tears up or something. It would be nice. Not tears up, damage up. For all intents and purposes, our damage really isn't all that spectacular on paper anyway. 5.88 is not impressive at all. Okay, yep. Sun card, might as well use it. Did not know the secret room was there, so might as well take a look. And it's going to be super greed. Super greed. Super greedy. Now you will not be able to unhear that, no matter how often you see super greed. You're welcome. I thought this was going to be the brownie room for some reason. I don't know why. We had a heated discussion on the live stream the other day. That wasn't heated. It was baked. When it comes to cake versus brownie. And, you know, I mean, cake versus pie, cake already loses. So then the natural evolution was, well, what about cake versus brownie? And the answer, because brownie and cake are kind of similar. They're kind of similar in a lot of regards. However, in my humble opinion, brownie easily wins. And I'll go a step further. Brownie beats pie. So if that means that cake beats pie, then I don't even know what universe we're living in at this point. But brownie is the top tier dessert / holiday pastry dessert choice, in my opinion. Now, I love me some pumpkin pie, don't get me wrong. Pumpkin pie and me, we're we're square. But Brownie is king. Second seed, Hotel 4 Bravo Delta, Kilo Papa Yankee Lima. I know that some people are wanting me to wind this one back a little bit to continue this discussion about Brownie versus, you know, the others. I'm a big fan of just the overall everything of brownies. You know, I'm not a big chocolate guy, but I do enjoy the chocolatey nature of, like, you know, of a warm brownie. There's something that's just magical about that. You don't get that with pie or with cake, in my opinion. We could take Jar of Flies. Like, we're really not using Book of Sin for anything anymore. Let's see what else we can get here. Mom's Bottle Pills is not great. Notched Axe, we had some fun with, but, and Stopwatch. Okay. Yeah, I think we're going to take Jar of Flies. So Jar of Flies is just going to add on to our damage here. Every time we kill an enemy, we're going to produce a fly. And because we have Spectral and Piercing tiers, more than likely than not, our damage is going to get to the enemies before the flies will, which means that we're going to constantly have a ring of flies around us. And we almost might as well be Guppy at that point, which I'm still hoping that we get. Something unbeatable about brownies, and I'm not quite sure what I can how to describe it. They're just good, you know? They're just good. And we really didn't want Tech 2. I mean, Tech 2 is good, don't get me wrong, but we just didn't want it on this run. Like, we were already kind of set on this run. Tech 2 kind of, I mean, we still get the piercing shots. We still get the, give me Glowing Hourglass. I mean, it's half price, so yeah, we'll take Voodoo Head. Okay, so I'm going to undo that with the Glowing Hourglass, and we're just going to take the Hourglass and Voodoo Head, because we know what's coming up next. The Glowing Hourglass is going to allow us to undo anything in the run, basically, as long as it has a full charge. Wormwood. There's our Spun Transformation Coach. An Eternal Heart as well. And we get Eye of Belial, which, it doesn't really do anything. We get it. Wait. Oh. All right, well, I was hopeful that it would have been worth it. Now we can't undo this unless we had Nun's Habit, which we don't. It was a good idea, though. It was a good idea undoing the Devil Deal there. Like that, just so we can check. That's actually pretty darn interesting. That's actually pretty interesting, is the fact that we can undo that and check what's in the Angel Deal. It's one demerit for every time I say pretty darn. I'm going to take that out of my vocabulary. The shot speed upgrade, which is not necessarily great for Death's Touch. Can I say pretty dadgum? Is that okay? Can you handle that, society? Pretty dadgum. Now, Goat Head plus this combo here that we've got with the Glowing Hourglass is very interesting, because now we have a guaranteed Angel Deal and Devil Deal. Well, that's not bad. and we can see exactly what is inside one and then go back to the other if we don't like it. Take Steam sale. We get a PH Dizzle at half price. Mom's Key at almost full price. Take Rune. So we didn't get an angel deal, of course. We get Bloody Gust, which is going to help us out greatly. Let's go back and see if we can find the key piece. There's really no risk at this point in this run just because of the simple fact that we've got the glowing hourglass. We can undo any damage. And now, especially with the stars card, we can get out of there even quicker. Excuse me. Clog is going to be no problem with us being as the lost. And should hopefully produce a good second item. A little extra bonus item that we get from doing the alt path boss. Or just doing alt path in general. The key piece here. We're going to go fly on over literally to the boss room. I don't know why I would use that in a figurative language. Flying, we're actually flying. And oh man. We've already got the spun transformation. We've already played with fire once. I don't want to lose this damage again. I would prefer if Death's List can give us even more damage than what we've got right now. It would be beneficial, and that will also be preferable. We have our first key piece here, and we're going to head on down to the mines or ash pit. Most likely ash pit, because that's just all we see. Caffeine pill. We'll head on to Zaun. Again, two cursed rooms here because of the voodoo head. Thought that we killed that one. That's the reason why I pulled off on it. I could have used the glowing hourglass to undo my entry into that that cursed room there. Yeah, trying to stick with the death list. Zack Dagger and another multi-dimensional baby. And a big, big explosive diarrhea. You didn't say it. Disappointed in you, Matthias. I mind, again, we're still looking for Guppy, so if we can get Guppy, that'd be good, but you know, if we can't, we can't. I'm gonna buy a couple soul hearts here. I'm not gonna buy all of them. Really, what I should have been doing is should have been buying these premium items first. Because we can just undo all this stuff if we don't find anything that we like. We don't, so I'm just gonna back on out of there. take Hive Mind again, and we know that there's nothing else to come out of that, so we'll just do this here. And I am gonna game the system a little bit here and use the glowing hourglass to my advantage. So if we do get a bad blind item, we can just simply undo it. Didn't actually mean to use it in here. I was looking at my hand like and talking about what I was going to do, and then I just used it. So we got a luck upgrade here. Let's go back into the item room. And then after this, we're going to need another full charge. Crack the skizzle, huh? Yeah, I mean, it didn't help us, so it didn't hurt us either, but it didn't help us. But we can now, at least we don't have to go get another full charge for our glowing hourglass. Hey, Gideon. Know that you were still alive. A singular luck upgrade. Oh yeah. Great Gideon, more like great idiot. Our curse room sitting right here. Did get a damage upgrade, so I'm not going to undo that. Yeah, we have PhD. Forgot about that. Was a diarrhea. Something's wrong. Real bones doesn't really do anything for us. Whoa! I did not know there was going to be enemies in here, game. We just got to confuse the shop owner, really. Drowsy, that's going to be pretty good against the mother fight we'll be doing. We don't even have to hit the yellow buttons here. We can just simply go to the mines and bomb our way into the minecart area. The reason I thought those were just spikes. I don't know why. There we go. Pardon me a moment. I got something in my eye. Like one of those eyelashes that like just doesn't go away. And Ryan... Northern Lion, he tried to say that I was weird by me telling him, yeah, whenever that happens, I just try to like, I don't try to yank the eyelash out, but like, I kind of like poke and prod and try to grab the eyelash. Like just to, if anything, at the very least, untangle it from being like curled over backwards and poking into my eye. At the very most extreme, like actually like taking the eyelash out. If it's loose anyway, it's coming out. So like, why not just remove it? You know, your eyelashes grow back pretty fast. Don't ask me how fast, but I know that it's, you know, not like it's not like the hair on your head, unless you're bald and Canadian. Oof, that was really, really bad. Not the Canadian blast. I mean, like the positioning on that last charge. I thought we were gonna get hit by that for sure. Let's send her back up before we go across here. The tarot card here for some reason. Let's see what it is. The Hangman card. Oh, that makes things a lot easier. Thank you. Pit boss. It appears to be a whose room would be that big? Right, you don't even get the glory of me clearing that room, game. I'm gonna rob that from you. Divorce papers. I think Angel Deals have been deleted from the game at this point. And so have Guppy items, apparently. All right. All righty. Go take the... Yeah, I'm going to stick with the I'm Drowsy pill here. Had a sort of a reverse Karen moment today where I had a so I got my latest PSA cards back, and these were not Pokemon cards. These were basketball cards mostly. There was one Pokemon card, but like it was a card that I pulled a long time ago, and it got a PSA 10. We got lots of 10s, which is good. But there were two cards in particular that were not good. One of them was a 10, and the other one was a 7, PSA 7. And when I say PSA, by the way, for those of you who do not know, no one lies with rags. We're talking about the graded card service that you can send cards to, sports cards, Pokemon cards, et cetera, that I use. You've seen videos of them on YouTube, and you've seen them on my channel, actually, as well. So we got one of these back, and I'll start with the lesser of the two, which was the LaMelo Ball. I got a PSA 10 on, but the case appeared to be cracked when we opened it, and I was like, what the heck? Like, this case is cracked. Like, I'm not planning on selling the card, but I also like wouldn't be able to sell the card with a cracked case. I mean, no one wants a cracked slab and for a card, you know. It looks horrible. You can't add that to a collection. So we spent the next like 2 days like freaking out about it. I emailed PSA, took all these pictures, and I was going to send it to them. And the PSA representative was like, hey, you need to go through our customer resource center on our website for complaints and whatnot. And I was like, there's not enough characters on there, blah, blah, blah. By characters, I mean like there's not enough like actual like characters. Like it's 500 total in this little text form that you can use, and that's it. So I started filling out stuff for the second card, which I will reveal now, which is the 2021 Anthony Edwards Lime Green Prism. Not Prism, Lime Green Refractor. Oh, we got a Planetarium. And that one is the biggest, is the bigger of the two problems. So that one was one that I pulled myself, and I was very, very stoked about getting it. Like, I don't watch basketball, but I collect basketball cards. But I don't really particularly care to watch basketball. And Anthony Edwards is, those of you who don't know anything about basketball, by the way, just know that that the man Anthony Edwards is one of, if not the top, I would say the top rookie pick of last year's rookie class. He's no longer a rookie anymore because the season just started. But just know that he's one of the top three that you can get. Him, LaMelo Ball, of course, which is probably considered number one, and then James Wiseman. So anyway, so I pulled a really rare Anthony Edwards card, and it was in mint condition, beautiful, absolutely no doubt, without a shadow of a doubt, it was going to be a PSA 10. Just bottom line, I instantly submitted it, and I was like, yeah, this is a no-brainer. So much to my surprise, it came back as a 7. And I was like, what in the holy heck happened? There's no way this card's a 7. Come to find out, we look at it and find out that there's a huge dent and scuff mark scratch on the card. And when I say, these spike rocks are getting out of control, man. When I say like huge, I mean like running down the length of the card, huge. Scuff marks and scratches on this card, and it's horrible. I mean, it's absolutely horrible. So the fact that it graded a 7, because it was sort of like a big mystery at the time, is like, why, like, what, how the hell did this card get a 7? Then, you know, we looked at the actual card itself and saw the scuff. It's like, okay, so they graded, so something happened to this card before they graded it. So, and the only thing that could have possibly happened was that whoever was grading the card damaged the card before they graded it. Now, I know that seems, you know, that seems pretty accusatory, and it is. Yeah, speedball. We don't have to do boss rush, by the way, but we can just get out of here. But we're going to do it anyway. So, yeah, that's pretty accusatory, but... It's the thing is that I can prove without a shadow of a doubt that not only the card was pulled at mint condition, we have it on video, but also the fact that the card was shipped in mint condition, because I have a picture of the day of the card, the day that I shipped it. I always, you know, this is the card that I was talking about the other day. So I did actually take pictures of the card the day that was shipped. And if you recall, for those of you who've been paying attention to the commentary the last couple of days, originally I said I didn't think that I had it on video. We actually did get it on video. It was my buddy who does a card opening channel. We actually got that one on video. So, fast forward, and find out that, you know, the card's been damaged. I sent in a request to have it looked at. And PSA is really only going to be able to give me the declared value of the card, and that's it, if they rule that they were negligent or whatever. And I mean, it's probably not going to go in my favor, but you know, it was such a beautiful card that like we just have to, I want it desperately to just have some kind of vengeance for being damaged, because it didn't leave my house here damaged, you know. So now where's the reverse Karen part of it all? Okay, so. What kicked this all off was me reporting the cracked slab. Found out today that the slab actually isn't cracked. There was someone, like, I guess the grader or the shipper's hair inside of the team bag that it was shipped in that was sealed along with the slab. And also, like, the team bag itself, which are these little tiny plastic, they're like form-fitted plastic bags, it also had, like, sort of like an indentation divot. Where the hair was, I guess, because someone also thought it was cracked and they were just scratching it or something. So it turns out that my PSA 10 LaMelo is not cracked, thankfully. Hey, that's gonna be pretty good for Infestation 2. We'll take the world card as well, and we'll head on, not Dizown. I mean, we're gonna go down, but we're not going down to the womb. We're going down to the corpse. Anyway, that's the update / repeat of what happened with my most recent PSA returns. There was a silver lining, because the card that I got is beautiful. It's a silver LaMelo rated rookie from the newest Optic series. Onrus Optic. people who don't follow trading cards are all like, we just get back to Isaac. I mean, yeah, we could get back to Isaac, but like, what are we gonna talk about? Like, man, this run sure is powerful. Like, we are absolutely blasting this run into the Yeetosphere. Rubber Cement's making just everything all hectic and crazy. We get Sackhead here. Luna's also gonna give us a nice little Tears buff. Suppose we could go in the curse room here. I'm convinced that Guppy transformations just don't exist anymore in the game. We haven't seen one in I don't know how many runs, but it's been quite a lot. We get an Emperor card. Let's go. There's our luck upgrade. I do want to go into the vault just to see what we can get. Okay. Get Incubus and Abadabba Ding Dong once again. Of course, we get the Conjoined transformation, which is just going to make things even more of a visual doo-doo. And we got Leviathan as well, which is also going to do that. Which, actually, not really, but we're just going to pretend it does. And we don't have to go into the vault, so I'm not gonna. So Empty Heart taking up a lot of our HP here. Not that it really matters, of course, because we're just dominating. Rubber Cement just turns this run into just something wacky. Just the wackiest. We did have a couple new patrons on Patreon as well. Thank you all very much for that. One of them had a question about when do names get added to the videos and whatnot. So the way that works, it's explained on the Patreon page. But just for clarification, in case if anyone doesn't know or if you're interested in doing it, but you're not sure how like everything works. Essentially what happens is when you sign up for my Patreon at any tier, your name gets added to a list after the payment's cleared the following month. Hey, look, that Guppy transformation that doesn't exist, it exists. Check that out. And after the payment clears, you get added not to the current month, but the next month. Because we've already gotten the list established from the previous month. So that's how that works. So, like, if you've signed up in October, like, let's say you sign up tomorrow on my Patreon, patreon.com/Invicta, in case you didn't know. If you sign up tomorrow, your name will get added to the Patreon shout-out list for next month, for November. So after November 1st rolls around, starting from November 1st and onwards, you have a chance of your name being read that day. Now, I say that, but everyone's names get read. So there's no chance, like, you're guaranteed to have your name read. I just don't know what day it's going to be on. It changes every month. We try to randomize it just for a little bit of variety, a little bit of spice. Gosh, are you seeing all the money? Down goes Mother. Now, hang on a second. We ain't done yet. You know why? Because there's a sacrifice room, boys and girls. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. We're doing another victory lap. Mother is down. Boss rush is down. You know we're going to go for it. That was awful. Let's try this again. Much better. Feel blessed. Holy poop. That It's not a good look for you there, Uriel. Or Gabriel. Ah, Curse of the Lost kind of kills my buzz, but Damocles gets it right back. Oh. Don't mind if I do. You ain't got to ask me twice, game. Oh my gosh. That has got to be one of the coolest looking brimstones I've ever seen. I mean, it looks like a trident. The stars card. Actually have to pay attention to this part here, which is very hard to do whenever you got like tons of flies and also like the world's craziest brimstone at your disposal here. Blessed Penny, this is where you shine here. Down goes Stanley. I don't know if Delirium spawned or not. We're not going to care. Because I didn't want to give Stanley... It did sound like we got through the animation of Delirium. Of not Delirium, but the Delirium portal, the Void portal spawning. But we take down Megastan. We've done Boss Rush. We've done Mother. We haven't done Old Hushy. We haven't done Mom's Heart. We haven't done anything on the light side of things. Oh, that's right, friends. Who knew on a Wednesday afternoon that you all, or Wednesday morning, or Wednesday evening, depending on where you are in the world, that we'd be going for the Omega Run with Damocles in tow. Now, I'm wondering if the Glowing Hourglass... I'm wondering if the Glowing Hourglass resets Damocles... Like, if it procs in this room and we undo it with the Glowing Hourglass, does Damocles just kill us right back again, or... Not sure. I go the Shades, as they're called, as the Mosh Pit was very quick to let me know. Oh, baby. Proptosis is going to give us massive damage up close, but horrible damage far away. Let's see how many items we lose. Round three. Third seed of the day. Why? That's literally the game shouting at us. Why? Okay, so we lost Spoonbender. We did not lose Guppy. Did not lose Death List. Did not lose Death Touch. Didn't lose the Compass. So I'm happy about that. We didn't lose Heartbreak. We did lose Restock. So that's something to be aware of. Get a reroll machine here, but unfortunately we're not able to spawn any... item pedestals, unless that was Head of the Keeper, which it doesn't look like we have anymore. The Bookhorn transformation, we did keep PH Dizzle. We get Hungry Soul. So in order for us to make the Omega run happen, we need exactly one. We need one R key or death certificate to happen. And I was hoping, and what I really should have done is I shouldn't have gone for the Soul of Isaac. What I really should have done is taken that reverse stars card and taken it into the secret room. That's what the plan was, but then my greed overtook my sanity, and I decided that I was going to go for the Soul of Isaac instead. It doesn't look like we did not keep the Infestation 2 either. We did keep Hive Mind, though, which is good. We keep Luna as well. Also good. Come on. We did not keep Duality either. We really don't need Devil Deals anymore. I'm going to go with Stapler for the damage up and head on to Zaun. Oh, we still keep the Devil Deal chance no matter what. Oh, you know what? We lost Voodoo Head as well. The reroll pedestal, but unfortunately no. Okay. It's gonna be real mad if there's an item there. We would have been able to undo it anyway, but yeah. Rat key. Yeah, that wasn't worth it. Two of diamonds. Evil Eye again, Stars card. So how do we make an item appear in the secret room? Is Curse the XL? No. Oh, that's right. You know what? I totally forgot that Luna gives you extra secret rooms. I totally forgot about that. Oh, man. That must have been driving people crazy that I haven't been looking for the other secret rooms. I was looking at a couple of those maps that we were going by and being like, man, that really looks like a secret room, but I've already been to one, so I don't know why we would have another one. Turns out it's because of Luna. I'm not talking about Luna Laterno either. Talking about Luna, the item. Golden key, we don't really care about that. Link Bundaloo and Blue Candida. Two items that we do not need anymore, thankfully. Damage is just getting out of control. Sick, nasty, crazy. That Proptosis, man, that did some insane things to our DPS. A world card, which is going to give us a crawl space, which could give us a death certificate or R key. It's going to take us into the I Am Error room. But I guess we can Glowing Hourglass out of there. D1 Hizzle. Found one. Still no item pedestal yet. The Soul of Isaac is going to be designed here specifically to re-roll the item pedestal that we find in the secret room if we get one. Which, I mean, we have a pretty decent shot at finding one because of the fact that we get extra secret rooms, so we're bound to find one. But if I had just taken and kept the reverse stars card, we may not have been in this predicament. But if we get an R key, or if we get a death certificate, which will eventually lead to an R key, game, I'm not re-rolling this. Like, I don't understand how much more do I have to say? Oh, you know what? We lost Damocles as well. I just now realized that we lost Damocles. I'm going to stick with the Book of Secrets only because I want it to show me where the secret rooms are. Really hoping that was going to be a reverse stars card. Let's go up to the other secret rooms real fast. That's the reason why we're not seeing any extra items, is because of the fact we don't have Damocles. Okay, well, here's an item pedestal. And before we do this, I'm going to go back. I'm going to grab the glowing hourglass in case if it doesn't reroll into something that we want. So it's only going to be the quarter or something else. Hopefully it's going to be something good. Soul of Isaac. It's not good. At all. Big school bag. This way we can at least take the Book of Secrets now along with the glowing hourglass. I'm down with that. Definitely do not want Demon Baby. Not that it really matters anymore, but like, I still don't want them, you know? No reason to have them. And we're finally going to go get to see what's inside of the crawl space down here. And possibly even use the Soul Isaac in here for this. Worth a shot, I suppose. No harm in it. We're still going to exit over here, though, just because of the simple fact that we just want to go to the next level. I think we will probably find... we'll most likely find a reverse stars card or reverse lovers card before we find a re-rollable item in the item room, like with a restock shop, a restock machine. I mean, would not be an item pedestal in here. Okay. The real question is, where are our other secret rooms? Ah, they are. We're getting the re-rolling machine, but not the item pedestal. Unfortunately. So we're now running out of floors here for us to get the death certificate or R key. Little Polly in doing some work here. Now save the Book of Secrets charge for the next floor. And if we end up not getting the Omega run, then this was just all a waste of time. Maybe not a waste of time. It's still fun to have these runs, you know. And we're totally dominating here. I actually don't even want old bandage, to be honest. Like, we definitely have more reasons to take old bandage than not. But is it something that we need? No. So I'm not going to lose perfection like that. Not happening. Gonna re-get all my keys back, because we definitely need them. It's sausage in here. Now sausage is a great item. One of the best all stats up in the entire game. We'll take sausage. Back, you foul beast. Get back, Chubb, and get back. You don't know me like that. Get back. I'm gonna bring this one back. Tears up there from Death's List, okay. I think the death certificate is starting to not look. The outlook of the death certificate probability is not looking particularly great anymore. We can still hope, though. We can still hope. I Guppy once again. We can go pretty hard here on this dark, this demon judgment. It's a reverse. Oh man, the reverse judgment card. We could have used that in the item room. The wafer's good too. We could have used the reverse judgment in the secret room. So now we have one half of the equation, which is us getting a reroll machine. Now all we need to have in one of our last couple of item rooms, in secret room I should say, is a chest that has an item or just an item pedestal. Care too much about the damage that we're taking here, even though it is a lot. We have wafer, we have double the HP, it doesn't really matter. We're just going through the motions now, trying to get ourselves an Omega one. The Omega run is something we've done before. If you don't know what the Omega run is, by the way, it is all bosses down, including all optional bosses and end game bosses, which means every single boss in the game, every single one, man. It's difficult to do. So our lists of bosses that remain are Mom's Heart. Oh. Well, well, well. Echo Chamber is not going to be it. Either's Esau Jr. That's definitely not it. I can't do it again without having a full charge. Let's see if we get another item pedestal in here. Item pedestal is what we need. We didn't, but we might be able to spawn one from these mushrooms. Okay, it's unfortunate. I'm almost 100% sure that the rerolls are seeded, but we can go back and just check real quick. Now, hang on a second. What if we used we can't get Echo Chamber without rerolling. Darn. I was going to say, what if we took Echo Chamber and then used the Judgment card? We'd be able to get a reroll pedestal every single time that we used a consumable at that point, which means that theoretically we could reroll every single item pedestal that we see inside the secret room. But then I remembered, oh yeah, we wouldn't have the reverse judgment. We would actually need another reverse judgment card, which we do not have access to. So another floor down. And we basically need to find another secret room with an item in it quick, otherwise we're gonna run out of floors. And Curse of Lost, which is going to make it very difficult for us to find these secret rooms. So I've got to pretty much check every single wall now that the secret room could possibly be on. But luckily, we're very good at this game and we know which walls that's going to be. Theoretically. Now, this could be pogged here. If the key judgment gives us some item pedestals in here, we could be looking at a certified pog moment. So, Butt Penny, how did you even get here? Get out of here. Okay, there's one. There's two. Okay, we don't want to use Pandora's box on depths two. If this was depths one, then, or if this were womb one, we have two item pedestals. Now, this is our best chance that we have. I don't know what Isaac's tomb spins down to, but that could be an avenue. Sadness and pain. Now hang on a second though. Hang on. I am gonna alt tab for this. I apologize in advance. In fact, I'm gonna go ahead and pause the recording real quick so I can look this up without having to waste your valuable time. Oh baby. Mosh pit, let me tell you something. I have found our death certificate. Courtesy of us being able to see into the future and then rewind time. We can take evil charm and spin down it. Spin down on it four times and get death certificate. An evil charm spawned after spin down die. Before we bung this up, let's go get a full charge here in case if I accidentally blow up the judgment. Did you see the shot speed in that thing? Okay. Before we bung this up, let's do that. Okay. Now I'm gonna see if we can. No. Let's just. It's best we just don't even open these chests. So what we need to do is this. We need to get Sci-Fly, and we need to get Pandora's Box out here again. Yeah. Then what we do now is we use the Judgment card. Reverse Judgment card. And then we get Spin Down Die. Okay, now we continue to roll until we get Evil Charm. There's the Evil Charm. Now we spin down, as you can see on the left, we spin down a total of three more times, and we will have Death Certificate, which allows us to get our key. Spin down once. We're going to back out, so it's permanent now in the glowing hourglass's mind. So all we need now is full charges. That's all we need now. My God, we're gonna do it. We's gonna do it. X gonna give it to you. Spin down, die again. We are one full charge away from pay dirt. We should have no problem getting that either because we have the jumper cables. We only need to clear two more rooms, basically one more room with combat to guarantee that we get it. And there it is. We're gonna get death certificate in the most long shot of ways. You love to see it. We're gonna hold on to the glowing hourglass just in case if we bung it up. Death certificate in tow. We are ready to go for what is probably going to be the fastest Omega run that we've had yet. Even though this run hasn't really been super duper powerful, I know that may seem a little disingenuous to say at this point. So what we can do, we can go fight old Hushy. We still need to beat Isaac though, is the problem. We have to hope that Delirium spawns after Isaac. If Delirium spawns after Isaac, then we will have our completed run. If it doesn't spawn after Isaac, then things become more complicated. So we're gonna take the mystery gift just in case. We can get a reroll machine and also get our, we can still naturally spawn an R key, I believe, at this point. So we have to make the decision now. Do we go after Delirium here? Do we fight Delirium now and then use the Archie? I mean, we're going to have to do that anyway. Or we could take a risk. We could take a risk and go after Isaac and then hope that Delirium spawns after Blue Baby. We don't have the Angel Key, Angel Room Key, so we cannot force a Mega Stanley fight. Unless we end up getting Dad's Key or we get get out of jail free card or something like that. Might actually still be better for us to take the Glowing Hourglass now that I think about it. In case something goes horribly wrong. Down goes old Hushy. I think taking the Glowing Hourglass is actually technically slightly better for us. There might be a secret room here that we can use the mystery gift on, though. Sometimes there is. Okay, not this time, but sometimes there is. Arrowcloth. I'm going to go ahead and pass on that. Do we risk going after... I say that we go after Delirium now, because we're going to have to do this anyway. We're going to use Death Certificate. Now comes the scariest part of the entire run. Not picking up something that we don't want. The only thing we want here is Archie at this point. And usually Archie is very tucked away. Sometimes it's up here. This time it's not. I have to make doubly sure. Really is terrifying navigating through the halls of the Death Certificate. Sissy! How you doing, little sissy? It's not usually in these big rooms here. It'll be coming up. No, not over here. All right, we're going the long way. Not the way that I wanted to go. You might be looking at this being like, wow, like, why are you making this so dramatic? Excuse me, don't ever do that. This is outside of your realm, sir. You might be saying, why are you making this so dramatic? Like, how could that possibly be... like nerve-wracking it until you like have something like an opportunity like this for an Omega run riding on you not accidentally misjudging your hitbox. You don't know, man. You just don't know. It's terrifying. Spin down die is also a consideration. Because it opens up the possibility of us networking to another Death Certificate. Which of course is going to lead to another Archie eventually. There it is. Ladies and gentlemen, We have our R key. Okay. Now we gotta do is just not die to delirium. So what do we need to happen on the next run? Well, there needs to be one of two things that happens. We either find another R key slash death certificate, which is possible but highly unlikely. Or the more reasonable of the two is that we find spin down die, or we find a sacrifice room in the chest, which is also highly unlikely. Basically, it'll be a lot easier if we can get spin down die or another death certificate or R key. Because here's the problem with us not this is the problem with us going to Isaac and then Blue Baby and then hoping that Delirium spawns. If Delirium doesn't spawn, we have to use the R key anyway, and then we have to go back fight Hush again, and then we would have to hope for another R key, which is, you know, almost not impossible, but it's almost impossible. Whereas here, all we need to get is a sacrifice room in the chest, which I don't even know if that's actually possible anymore. Or the more likelihood of the two is that we find spin down die or reroll pedestal inside of a secret room for an entirely new run, which is doable. That is feasible. The Book of Virtues here, which I don't know what that does with. I actually don't know what that does with the glowing hourglass, but I guess we're gonna find out. This is definitely where the run slows down quite a bit. And the ultimate boss, the final boss that we absolutely cannot get out of no matter what, is going to be Beast. So we got to go fight old Beastie. Dogma. Really, it's just Delirium, Blue Baby, Isaac, Dogma, and Beast in that order that we're missing. That's it. That's it. That is all bosses done. Fun card, might as well take it. You know the Delirium's... Well, we don't know the Delirium's one of these, but we hope it's this one. Not. As far as why do this, I don't know. The Omega run was something I came up with that would just, it seemed like a new challenge, you know? We like to go for the full house runs back in Afterbirth Plus. And this is the new full house run, although it does take a long, long, long more, a lot more time to accomplish, and also a lot of like luck and nuances with the items that you get. But since the introduction of R key and death certificate now, we have the chance to do it. There we go. So Delirium. Officially dead. R key it up. And away we go. Now we still get double item rooms. We still get double secret rooms, not item rooms. Reverse Emperor. You know, I'm kind of done with Reverse Emperor cards, to be honest. I think that they're... I think given how buggy they are, I just don't think that they're worth it. There's Hierophant and a Judgment card, which I definitely don't want. I'm just going to go ahead and undo that. This way, I mean, we'll have we can do the Reverse Emperor card, and then we can Glowing Hourglass out of there in case if it bugs out or we get Mom. It's squeezy. Also get the screw, which is gonna give us a nice tears up. We're gonna fly through these here. So the goal of this run will be to essentially to get to Blue Baby and just beat a normal run. And hope that we get another death certificate or R key. And then from there, the last thing that we have to do is essentially we just need to go beat Beast, and that's it. We can take Diplopia. Diplopia will give us a chance to double the item pedestals that we get inside of a secret room. I'm really hoping that we end up getting the blue map. That would be very useful. How did you get over here? Let's try that again. Should have another secret room. Yeah. Use the sun card here to make sure that we don't miss out on that. Gonna fly all the way back down here. And you know what? I'm not thinking about this in 4D. What I could have done there is I could have just saved that sun card so we always had a sun card to use. On any given floor. Because what I can do with that is that I can just simply use the sun card, memorize where the position of the secret rooms are, and then just simply undo it with the glowing hourglass. So that was kind of a goof on my end, but not a huge goof, I don't think. An angel deal here. And it conjoined once again. Curse the XL is not what I wanted to see. We get Saturnus and Luna again. Now, is this going to add another secret room? I feel like it's probably not going to. At this point, who knows? Getting a sun card wouldn't be bad here. Really kicking myself for not thinking of that earlier. Warm is good. Yeah, because we need to know where the secret rooms are on an XL floor like this. I mean, Moon card at least brings us to the other secret room. Okay, so we know that it's not, we know there's no item pedestal here. So that's, I mean, the moon card is not bad. That means that we only have to find one and only one secret room now. And then the moon car can take us to another one. So it's not quite as good, but yeah, it'll suffice. Unless we get a third secret room on every room, on every floor, I should say, with another Luna, but I don't know if that's how it works. Is anyone seeing the shot speed here? This is out of control. Now, Ragmega didn't even have a chance in that one. All right, we're on depths one. We know where one secret room is, thankfully. Okay. Now we can go find the other one by way of the moon card that we use right now. Got a whole lot of nothing in it. Got it. Just on the opposite end of that one as well. Now what we're focusing on, we're going to put our attention to wards, will be to getting a reverse judgment card or something like that so we can spawn an item inside of the secret room. That way we can get ourselves a guaranteed pedestal in there and then just simply reroll until we get our R key. I think we can still get R key, I think, but this is a question that I always bring up every time we try to go for an Omega run. I'm not 100% sure on that. Or we could try to find spin down die and then force one again. Unless it's greed, then we just simply don't get anything out of our shop, and that's fine too, I guess. Because even if we find an item pedestal right now, we have no way of re-rolling it. Unless if like the stars align and we somehow get a reroll machine and an item pedestal inside of the secret room. The complicated process. I mean, it really isn't, but like, yeah, it's really not that complicated. We just got to get lucky. Okay. Okay, so that one is at the opposite end of this hallway here. So we know that there's going to be a secret. Oh my god. Going to need a replay of how fast that. No, Isaac. Come on now. Need a replay to see how fast that Dinga got yeeted. Okay, so we have an item pedestal in there now with order. Now we just need a way to re-roll it. This is where the Eye of Guppy really helps out quite a lot. Compass. Soul Converter. We don't have any tarot cards here. There's no other way for us to actually get a reroll in there. Unless if we get the D6 to show up in the boss rush, which we've already missed, so never mind. So now we're looking at the possibility of we need a sacrifice room to spawn in the chest. Is basically what needs to happen here. So that one is underneath the boss room, mini boss room, but there's basically no reason for us to keep looking because this is it. There's no item pedestal. We have no way of creating one. We have no way of re-rolling one. We still have Diplopia. And the reason why I wanted Diplopia was because I wanted to increase our chances of basically increasing multiple or making multiple item pedestals inside the secret room. Pheromone treatment, still not going to take you even on a winning run. Okay. Starting to get down to the nitty gritty now. No item pedestal in there. Nor in here. Of course, there is a sacrifice room on this floor, but that doesn't really help us do much except just give us another seed to try to do this again. And with the run now approaching 2 hours and 3 minutes, I think everyone would be satisfied if we just wrap it up here. Angel deal. Genesis also gives us a chance. Now we can use Genesis after we fight Blue Baby, and then we gotta hope that we can get an R key. Is it possible? Is it possible? Could we get that lucky? Mega Mush is an item pedestal, but we have no way of re-rolling it. This rock bottom. We're gonna take rock bottom because it is a secret room item. I'm hoping that Genesis will give us plenty of chances to re-roll through. So Genesis is our ticket to salvation here. Say I'm not overly enthused with the fact that we got Curse of the Lost here. So will Genesis once again be the big time player that we need? The savior of the Omega Run possibility has once again appeared. Kind of wish we didn't have Brimstone now, I'm just going to be honest. And I also wish, really, really wish we didn't have Curse of the Lost. All right. Where the hell do we go? This is the game's only way to troll us at this point, is just giving us Curse of the Lost and making me run in circles until I die of old age. How's it possible that we've gone everywhere that we could have gone? Bruh. So we go beat Isaac, get to the chest. Then what we're going to do is we are going to beat Blue Baby, then use Genesis, and then hope that Genesis either gives us an R key or death certificate. Now, we can't immediately use that We cannot immediately use Arky or Deathless, or not Deathless, but Death Certificate, because remember, we still have to go fight Beast. So we're still going to need some items from Genesis. But this all hinges on us actually getting the item. I'm picking up these extra items just in case, just to increase our chances of getting items. Down goes Blue Baby. And there was a Delirium portal, of course. So here we go. Genesis, take us home. All right, there's no going back now. You know, the stairway could be another way that we could get help out of another Genesis, basically. We get Birthright. Didn't really help us there, Birthright, not gonna lie. When did we get Hamalac? Oh, it's because we're eaten, that's right. Yeah, give me consolation prize for the tears, movement speed. Pluto Soul Venus. E Bizzle. Wafer, take Luck Foot. Tint Oil. Squeezy. Got the Spun Transformation already. I'd love to get my Guppy item, or Guppy Transformation back if possible. Hamalacria Brimstone is quite good. Let's hope it doesn't crash the game. We can't. We can't take Damocles here. Damocles plus Genesis also crashes the game, by the way. Yeah, I guess restock. Use the shadow. Our second planetarium item. Take Mercurius. We can run through doors. Still not seeing it yet. I think our tears rate is actually capped now. Yeah, it is. Oof, I don't like any of these. Big Tough Love. Kidney Stone is ridiculous with Brimstone and Hamalacria. I'll take Starter Deck. Moving Box. Glitch Crown. We're gonna put the pressure on. Not a good start if I miss that. Hinge Eater's there. I'm trying to get Inner Eye here. Yeah, that was better. We do not want Dr. Fees. In fact, I'm not even going to give us the option of possibly screwing that up. Yeah, there's only one answer here. They're not seeing it yet. It's not particularly reassuring. Really matter. Twisted Pair might actually destroy the game. There's our Guppy transformation, which we do not need. Actually gonna go with Capricorn, I think. Still looking for it, not seeing it. Cancer's a good pickup here. You can go Halo here. Worm Buddy is not bad either. We might actually take Tech 2 just to make sure the game doesn't crash. Or we'll get Jawbone, I guess. Magic Skin. Looks like we're getting into the secret room. Cool now. There's Psyfly, so we gotta be getting close. D6 is there. Magic Mush. The Fungi transformation. Knockout drops. Cannot take Jacob's Ladder. That will actually crash the game. In fact, I'm going to make sure that we don't have to worry about that. We just re-roll this, too. Ooh, breakfast is not good. I think that's it. Don't think we're getting it. Oh. Alabaster Box. Look at Virtues. That's gonna do it, unfortunately. Oh, so close, man. So close. Well, hang on now. Hang on. Is it over or is it not over? Because we still have a chance to get... Oh, my God. Look at the sparkly... I think I accidentally turned to the Lost there. I had the Soul of the Lost real quick. We still have the Delirium Portal, so it's not, I guess, technically over yet. That is the pinkest, purpliest brimstone Hamolacry I've ever seen. We got Sissy! How can I forget? We're going to get a charge on the D6 here, so I don't know if we can reroll back into Magic Skin. I'm guessing probably not. Now, another possibility here is that we could find another sacrifice room and restart the run. Give us a victory lap, and that would reset the loot tables. So we still have some outs yet. It's not over yet. It may appear to be over, but we have to hope that there's a sacrifice room in the void, which I don't know if it is, if that's possible or not. And there's not. I mean, we can't buy these at all, unfortunately. So unfortunately, Genesis struck out for us. And I don't know if there's any way to get a new run here now. With there being absolutely no way of creating a different run. That's just gonna breakfast out. I think the only thing that we can do is hope for Magic 8 Ball. Not Magic 8 Ball. Yeah, this is me being tired now. I think the only thing that we can do is hope that we get Magic Skin. I really need to be letting Darkbum actually pick these up. Because if he gives us enough soul hearts to get in to create an item pedestal with Alabaster Box, then we can use that in a secret room and maybe re-roll into that, into an R key or death certificate. I really did think that Genesis was going to give it to us, though. I thought that was a done deal. Okay, that's good. There's rerolls in there. But I feel like if we didn't see it in Genesis, then we're seeing breakfast items, we're probably not going to see the R key again. Come on, y'all. Okay, you know what? You don't even have enough keys to open anything. Hunt's Habit. Okay. So we essentially have... It's not essentially. We do have unlimited rerolls now. There's the Pact. That did okay. That gave us what we needed for Alabaster Box. Now let's try to find the other secret room, just in case if there's an item pedestal in there. I'd like to see. I'm just gonna try everywhere that it could be here. Moon card would be greatly appreciated right now, game. We don't have enough bombs. All right, we don't want to ruin our. Let's just use it now. See if we get lucky. We got a restock machine in here. No way. As not deathless as act of contrition. We're seeing other items here. DM trainer one up is not what we wanted to see. Yeah, it's over. That's unfortunate. All right, well, after all that, 2 hours, 23 minutes later, we get denied of the Omega run. I tried my best, everyone. We have no way of restarting this run now. No way of restarting this run. Oh my mega. Apologies, Jam Jar Boy. Oh man, we have Mama Mega and Mercurius. Four and a half volt ain't gonna cut it. Yeah, I don't think there exists anything in the game that that now can save us. That item pedestal judgment combo in the secret room that we just had was it. That was our last gasp. But oh well. We tried, we had fun. It was a blast. So thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Sorry we didn't get there at the end of the day. But you know what? We'll try better next time. We'll try to plan a little bit better and hopefully get lucky as well. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you again, everybody, for all the support on the Like Street goal, all the support on the Isaac series in general, as well as welcome all new subscribers here to the Mosh Pit. It's a pleasure to have you here. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Oi Skull WTF, Anthony Agresta, Mr. Alcatraz, Aaron York, Arigas, and Maddie. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/sinvicta.